In most of our communities, the plight of widows is often a neglected one. Once the husband dies, most of the properties are distributed to clan members, and this has become a concern to the judiciary in Gulu.
When women lose their spouses, their pain is compounded by a long period of suffering. You are living with your husband very well. You have now died. Your brothers now want to take over.
Justice Philip Odoki adjusts his glasses as he peers through and emphasizes that there must be a fight against wife inheritance and name calling.
That wife inheritance is regarded as sexual violence. It's one of the repugnant cultures of Africa that we must fight.
The members of the judiciary raised this concern during a dinner organized by Redeem International in order to commemorate the International Widows Day. The Gulu resident state attorney Toskin David identifies the greed for land by clan members as a driving force for the suffering of widows across Uganda.
I must say that because before I came here, I was working in Congo, and the same cases were being brought, land grabbing and matters to do with widows and orphans.
The message by the resident state attorney resonates with the life story of Palma, a resident of Amuru district who lost her husband in 2010 and was subsequently inherited by his brother, only to be abandoned and chased away from her marital home after conceiving one child.
For 8 years, I underwent untold suffering after my husband died. I was chased away from my land. Today, I am happy that I have been helped.
Palma was invited for the dinner with the judiciary after her case was successfully handled with the support by Redeem International, an organization that looks at helping widows affected by land conflict.
We can't estimate exactly how big the land is because they are scattered in different places. There are 9 gardens. She's grateful. The time when Redeem took on her case, she had lost all hope in life. But now she's very happy.
The United Nations records that there are 258 million widows in the world. The figures are very high in the areas that have been affected by war, such as Iraq, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Northern Uganda. The Gulu City Resident Commissioner, Amongin Jane Francis Okili, observes that widows and orphans need all our support during and after the death of their head of family.
But as we look at our culture, let's think of sensitizing our people. It is ignorance and lack of knowledge.
While men are also being encouraged to keep family documents in the know of their wives and children.
If you're a man, your wife may die. Or if you're a wife, your husband may die. We are afraid to think about it. But this is a hard reality. Anytime, if you're a woman, you can be a widow.
The International Widows Day was adopted by the United Nations General Assembly on the 21st of December 2010, and it is celebrated every 23rd day of June as a reminder of our responsibility to safeguard widows. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news.